Good evening, friends. Today we'll have a discussion on measurement of works. Measurement of works is a very important part in your civil engineering. You would have done a paper on measurement of works earlier also. However, I would like to brush your knowledge for those of you who are who have done this, and for those of you who have not done this course on quantity surveying, I hope you find this also useful. So why do we measure works? We need to measure our works because we need to know what we are doing. Most of the work which you did in your whatever you have done in your project schedules, all of them are a reflection of the work, quantum of work which is required. Okay, so one of the questions in your CAT 2 was on the network, right? What was the network question that you had? What you had to develop? You had to develop 3 alternate paths in foundation, right? So you need to know how much. So we didn't ask you to measure, put the time in. The reason is we know that you are not familiar with the concept of how to put the time for a activity, but in practice what you do, you will measure the quantity or quantum of work, and based on the quantum of work you're going to estimate the time. Okay, so measurements are a very important role. And from when do you start measuring things? Okay, common items of measure. How do you measure for instance sugar? Come on, yeah, don't tell me you don't know that. In kg. Okay, your petrol in liters. Okay, so you have standardized certain items of commodities which you buy. In the same way, your items of work in civil engineering are also measured. Okay, so this is most of the drawings which are photographs are from in and around VIT. This is a drawing, and if you're not able to see too clearly, it's a drawing of a foundation layout for the new building which is coming behind our CTS campus. Okay, so here we are having a drawing spread out. What I want to say is, whatever role you are taking as an engineer, the language one will speak to the other is in the form of drawings, and the drawings play a very important role in communicating a lot of things. Okay, one of the things is also quantity. This is a typical drawing which you have. Okay, I'm just going to zoom into a particular area. So you are going to have grid lines. The grid lines, yeah, it's going to be very obvious that you are going to measure it in meters. Okay, so you can find the length and quite a lot of things from a drawing. So for instance, in this drawing, brickwork is spanning between these two columns. So once you know the length, once you know the height of the system, you are definitely going to be able to give the dimensions. Okay, so there are dimensions for everything, and based on this you are going to work out quantities. Okay, so for instance, in this there we have got some windows by the mark, and here this is the elevation which we are having, the elevation or the height which I was talking about. It's all marked here, and I know this is very common knowledge, but look at these windows. These windows are many times they are measured in numbers. So what is the number of windows which you have, and what is the size to which it has to be done? So various kinds of windows could be there. There could be a opening for a ventilator. In this case, this is a ventilator for which it was given. So you got also the staircase and other items. Now one of the important things which this drawing is giving is the specification. Okay, see here it's saying that you're going to give a weathering course. You're going to have an RCC slab, and you're going to have a 230 mm thick brick wall. Okay, so I in another drawing we'll be looking at the specification. Now one of the very important things is all the dimensions which you have will be in millimeters. Okay, but elevations are always given in meters. This is one of the cardinal rules in dimensioning or in measurement that you should remember. I'm not going to go too deeply into why or what of it. And see here, there is the specification. So if you are going to ask in the contract, how is it that the person is going to know what is going to come? This is how it's going to come. In the sight, the person is going to have this drawing. Many times, these drawings will go through the buyer. So the buyer will have his engineer who will go through the specification, and he will ensure that it is to the contractual requirement. Okay. For example, we have everything from anti-termite treatment, painting specification, jointing specification, and we also have some other miscellaneous specification. So for instance, this is what we are talking about, doors and windows. The moment you have this size, you know the type of material the window or door is going to be made of, or the rolling shutter is going to be made of, immediately you are going to be able to get the cost. Again, if you have that, you can say, if you are going to produce that window, you can say my carpenter is very good. How much time he is going to take for making a window or for to fix a window? So this is another thing which you get from the carpenter. I'm having quite a lot of photographs taken inside VIT, okay, from VIT, and so a few are from outside also, unique structures which we might not have here. So I'm going to give you a little deeper idea around foundation. In other words, I mean, it's not very deep or anything. I will be spending a little time on foundation. You please go through the rest of the works. Okay, this is all there in the IS 1200, which gives you the method of measurement of works. Okay, so now these are some of the general provisions, or these are some of the general things which you have when you are looking at measurements. So what are these? First and foremost, you will be clubbing items of similar nature. Okay, so when you are having a measurement done, okay, in a general, I'm just talking to you in terms of a general construction engineer, okay, site engineer or anything, a project manager. So you are going to give a lot of bill of materials, and the first step is in a bill of materials, you'll club all the similar works. For example, what are the similar works? Excavation, okay, then maybe your PCC work under footing, and then your RCC work, and so on and so forth. So RCC will be one major chapter, painting will be one major chapter. So this is what we mean by saying that we are going to have different we are going to club similar items of work. Then the dimensions are booked. What do you mean by booking of dimension? Entering dimension inside your measurement book is booking of dimension. Okay, so this is the order in which you're going to give. And I'm sure that you would remember that in quite a few things you have been using this length, breadth and height sequence. Now this bill of quantities or bill of materials, that book will specify the way the work has been done. Okay, all the things which you have done is going to be explicitly put. So what do we do, say for instance, for example, if you're going to do backfilling, any general idea as to how backfilling is going to be done? Backfilling will not be done, it will be done in layers less than 150 mm. You are going to compact it nicely. Minimum 3 layers are going to be done. Now this specification, do you remember this in any of the experiments which you have done? How many of you are taking a course in soil mechanics in this semester? Nobody. Okay, all of you completed soil mechanics then? Okay, I gave a description. Have you heard that description anywhere? You should use 3 layers. Which one? Correct. Okay, so you see, just try to relate what you have studied in your theory, which is totally different, into the field of construction. Okay, so this is a specification which you do in your backfilling. So you say that you are going to backfill it at what moisture content? Your optimum moisture content, and that, so this is the back end engineering which people have done. How backfilling, if it is done, it's going to be best. So that is going to be done in the back end. They are going to give this data to the site engineer, who will be one person just like you, and it may even be you. So there all the details are put in. How you are going to do the plastering, what is the mixed proportion you have to do. You may not be asked to do the mixed design in a big company, but what you'll be expected to do, you'll be expected to follow the instructions which are given. Okay, so the work will also be accurately described. Okay, now excavation is something like you're just making a pit. Okay, so this is a pit which was done for that new block which is coming behind the CTS office. Now this is a very shallow excavation, less than 2 meters. Okay, less than 2 meters, 1 meter, and stuff like that. So here they have not done much special work. However, if you are going to go for a very deep excavation, for instance, if you are going to construct a structure with a basement, okay, basement of two levels, it will be minimum, okay, at a very bad minimum, 7 meters of excavation. So what is this 7 meters of excavation? It will be around 1.5 story deep, to put it in perspective. I'm saying that the headroom inside the basement is very less. Okay, so 7 meters, I'm just putting it. So if you're going to take the raft footing and other preparation, it will be another 1 meter, so 8 meters of cut is there. So almost 2 story deep. So at that time, you cannot do in this manner. So under such circumstance, you adopt a different standard of measurement. Okay, and okay, usually what happens is some items of work are measured in various levels. Okay, I thought I'd put it in the slide, but it's not there. So what happens is you will have a different rate and a different specification. For instance, if there is a pit of 3 meters deep, you will not be allowed to, usually the first level is 0 to 1.5 and 1.5 to 3 meters. Reason is, now as a construction engineer, you go to site and then you have a very deep pit. So there's a chance that the soil can fall down on the person who is digging a pit which is 3 meters. Now, soil falling is common. However, in this pit, if soil falls and a man is standing, what happens? He's going to be buried maybe up to the chest level, right? He's still alive. He's not going to be in great danger. So that is why you in soil excavation, they go for various depths. Well, let's go for a high-rise building. If it's a G+1 building, what is the special thing which you have to do? When you're concreting, you'll have to think of a method to take concrete to a much greater height than the first floor. Okay, so whether it's going to be economical to have a human ladder or you're going to have a bucket elevator to take up the material to the top floor, or are you going to pump the concrete? So many such decisions are going to be involved, which also have a cost implication. So what they do is they'll keep dividing the same work as we go vertically upward or vertically downward. Again, work which is done in water or underwater, that will be dealt with separately. Okay, and so these are some of the places where some hardship is encountered. For instance, if you work underwater, you cannot do any operation like concreting or anything. You will have to compulsorily dewater. Okay, so dewatering, suppose you are in a very dry area and then you have water in your construction site, you will not be in a you can just use an ordinary pump and dewater it. However, suppose you are working near a lake or a river, the water table is extremely high. The moment you start to dig, water is just going to fill up the gap immediately. So sometimes what they'll do, they'll have to drill separate wells around the construction site and then they'll have to pump the water from the well. Dewatering points will have to be established. So the cost will proportionally go up. Okay. So when you are going to make your bill, okay, the first thing you do is you measure the work. So that and then the billing should be, the payment should be in proportion to the work which you have executed. So you will have to say what sort of work which you have done and how much you have done. Okay, so for instance, these are some of the classification of soil. Yeah, tell me please.
Sir, I have a question. A lot of the work which has to be done and the estimates based on the work depend on the location where the work has to be done.
Yes.
Like depend on the site. So a lot of the costs are very site dependent.
Yeah.
So when there's a contract which, a tender which is being submitted, how do you take that into consideration and come up with an estimate?
Okay, see, the question is, cost is dependent on the area where you work, and that is the only point which you're raising. So how you are going to find a cost in the tendering stage, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, see, this was a question which somebody asked me very recently, so the answer is also very fresh. Now, basically, if you are going to do a contract, the work is justified by using the cost is justified using the CPWD manual of works. Okay,
it has the method to do the costing. Okay, how to do the costing, and also what are the items which are involved in the costing. Okay, so once you get the cost, this is the benchmark cost. Each state has a PWD office, so they will correlate the work, and then they will match, they will scale up the cost. It will be more or it will be less. For instance, if you look at Tamil Nadu PWD's thing, for taking materials by bullock cart, that is also one head which is there. The cost is slightly different in certain areas. If you are going to work in Ooty, Kodaikanal, that side, the work, of course, now bullock carts are not being used, but the, it is still there, and maybe they have put an amendment. But so the cost is different for the method you are taking. If you are in the hills, specifically they say this areas have an escalation allowance of so much. So this is the way by which at the tender stage you will be able to estimate the cost. First thing, measure the quantity of work. Okay, then estimate what is the kind of methodology which you are going to adopt. Like for instance, here I told you, in certain areas we know what is going to come. For instance, there is a very massive structure in material handling called wagon tippler. Wagon tippler goes very deep into the, nearly 40 meters also sometimes, under the ground. So 40 meters, can you imagine what is 40 meters? 40 meters is around an 8-story building approximately. Okay, 8 or even 10-story building. You're going so deep inside the ground, and definitely water table is going to be encountered. Now if you're going to work in a place where there is going to be a lot of rainfall, like in Maharashtra, certain areas monsoon is going to come, and this is not going to be excavated overnight, cannot be excavated and filled up overnight, so they will have to take a dewatering strategy. So there the cost is coming in, cost is known. Okay, most of these costs when you work out, you will also have to build in your profit somehow. You will have to build in a profit, and some exigencies are also going to be done. So all these will be put into the costing, and if you miss out something, it's going to be your loss. Okay, I hope I answered your question. Any other question, please? Okay, let me go back. So again, here for instance, we are having the head that hard rock is there, and hard rock in certain areas blasting is not allowed. Okay. For so if blasting is not allowed, okay, because of the presence of, for instance, there was a power plant very close, there was a power plant expansion, and again there was a wagon tippler to be installed, and this site was on hard rock, so they told no blasting is permitted, because if you blast, the shockwave will get transferred to the working power plant. So there was a limitation. So hard rock, how you are going to work without blasting? You may have to use acids to break the rock. Rock breakers have to be used. So many things are there. But the cost of doing all this is much more than what you do in the normal method. I mean, like if you're using blasting. So how you are going to do your backfilling? Okay. And see, the funny part of the thing is, what I want to impress in this lecture is, each item of work is being measured in a different way. Each item of work is measured in a different way. I don't know if anybody is here who took quantity surveying under me last time. Wonderful. Okay. So, do you remember what is the unit of measure for surface dressing? Unit of measure for surface dressing. Sorry? Meter square. Good. Okay. See, surface dressing is a kind of excavation where you do 15 centimeters max of excavation under certain very specific conditions. So that is measured in meter square. However, the rough excavation, what you do, is measured in meter cube. Again, surface excavation on certain counts, on very specific terms or specification, it is measured in meter square. But by and large, almost all the excavation is done in meter cube only. Okay, so you need to understand or know what is the unit of measure in which you are working. Okay, so now this is in the excavation, I dwelt a little longer than what you know I might have liked to dwell on, but for the others I will not be dwelling to that level. Okay, so you please go and have a look at the IS 1200 series
and find out what are the various units of measurements. Okay, for instance, this is reinforcing rods. These are measured in tons. Okay, but these kicker boxes, column boxes, these are measured in numbers. Okay, this is going to be kept in the base of the column just before they put the shuttering for the column, or the column box is put up. Now, what happens here? What happens here? If suppose you are having 1,000 columns to be done, you don't need 1,000 of these boxes. You need to plan your work to that level that you know exactly how many you will actually use. If you are going to buy more than the stuff you require, it's not going to be helpful. Okay, so of course this is another look at the reinforcing rods which are placed. Reinforcing rods are measured in kilograms or in tons. Okay, you will have to specify the diameter of the rod and the tonnage which you require. One of the things which happens in design is, even before the design starts, much before the design starts, you will be asked to place orders. They will say, give us an indicative number of how many tons of 16 dia rod you need, 20 dia rod you need. The cost of the rebar also, for instance, a 32 dia rod will have much higher wastage than a 12 dia rod. You do the math, okay, that is, you know the development length, etc., etc. Okay, so you will find out how much the rods come in, the higher diameter rods comes in fixed lengths, around 16 meters or 12 meters. So if suppose you are going to use only 8 meters of the bar, then the rest of the 4 meters of a higher diameter bar might not be used in any part at all. You cannot use it in any part. You may be requiring it for columns. So the wastage goes up to a very large extent. So when you are doing the design also, you have to be very careful. Sometimes some very enterprising site managers will buy a lot of 20 dia rod, and then they'll say you should use only 20 dia rod in your design, whether it's economical or not. So quite a lot of such things will keep coming up. Okay, and in this particular site, I just saw that they are using a precise level and tape. Okay, so this is what probably you'll get in most of the construction sites also. Okay, and if you're lucky, you'll get a draftsperson, or I mean a surveyor, who will be usually a diploma holder with a theodolite. Okay, this is the steel reinforcement measurement book. Okay, if you are not able to see it, this is the dia of rod, the numbers and the length. Here they'll give the bar shape. What is this bar shape? How many of you have given bar marks? What's a bar mark? Bar marks are reinforcing rods which are having the same shape and same diameter. Okay, so for instance, this particular reinforcing, this column tie is made of quite a few elements. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 elements are there. So each of this will have a shape and it has a specific diameter. Okay, so it means that the individual shape is allowed to be given a unique number. Okay, sometimes for each drawing sheet they'll have a number, because for a project you cannot afford to have individual numbering. Okay, so this one will give the shape, whether it's L shape, whether you are having a crank up, or whether it's any other specific shape. Okay, and the length and diameter. Once you know the length and diameter of the rod, you can very easily measure the weight. Okay, so this is done in any construction site. Okay, this is about a little bit of excavation and reinforcement. Here we come to piling. Piling is always done in numbers. Diameter of the pile will be given, and a running meter. The pile is measured in running meters. Okay, the pile cap will be measured in meter cube, much like any other work. So grating, you will have to specify what sort of grating is there. Okay, what is the thickness of the grating, and it's measured in square meters. But you'll end of the day make your orders in kgs. Okay, kgs or tons only. And this is a huge shed. Okay, this is a primary crusher. The primary here, mining dumpers will come and dump materials. Now, can you see the size of this man and the size of this column base? The man is closer to the camera. The base is quite far. Okay, of course, there is a pedestal also here. To be a little fair, but this is a very massive structure. Okay, so here, this is a steel truss. This is a crane girder. This is the columns which are there. And Here you will measure all these items in kgs or tons only, and this side sheeting, this is the side sheeting and this is the roof sheeting, these are measured in square meters. Then you got a ridge piece, the ridge piece will be measured in running meters. Okay, so in all of this, whatever you do, you will also have to ensure that you are going to get your wastage in place. Now this gusseted base plate has gussets which are cut from a square section. So what you do here is you only give your measurements based on the square section. So the rest of the stuff is wastage. This is just a small piece of information which I thought I will share with you. Okay, here this is primary crusher house before it was constructed. If you see here, this is, it's a circular structure over here. What they did is they just removed all the soil. They didn't excavate only for this. They cut the entire mountain. Then they made the structure. Then they filled it up again to finally get this shape. Okay. So this is one way by which you can do the construction. So at site, they may decide that instead of doing a circular pit, we'll as well cut the entire mountain. So at that time, what happens? The cost, your excavation cost might go up because your original excavation was planned in a different way. But what is happening now? Maybe the speed of construction is going to increase. Okay. So this is another view of the, this is actually the tertiary crusher. Okay. And here you can see the gantry girder and the steel work in progress. So you will have girds for supporting the side sheeting, and you'll have purlins also, which are here, but you may not be able to see it. Okay. In this one, it's seen better. These are the secondary structurals. Okay. The primary structurals are the columns and beams. Then you've got these supports for side cladding. Okay. Side cladding is here. And also you got some windows which are put here. Now, one of the things which you have studied is staggering of connections. Okay. So you will see that the splicing of the works is not done at the same level. Okay. Maybe this is a little bit of a practical thing. Like if you're going to the design office, you will have to know this. And okay, this is a cruciform section which is nothing but a plus. They'll take a I-beam, cut it and put it in place. Okay, I'll just go far. I'm not going to spend too much time on any of these slides, but of course this is just an interesting building which I came across in one of my visits. And you can see this is a base with lot of small pedestals. Okay, so you can imagine how you can, and the thing which I wanted to talk about is the pockets. See, pockets are also measured. Why are pockets measured? Because you'll have to grout the pockets. What is a grout? Grout is a cementitious material which is pumped into a space. Okay, usually in cracks also you grout, and also in this gap between the base plate and a pedestal also you'll be grouting. So when you're grouting, you have a huge hole here for the shear key. Okay, what is shear key? The transverse force on the column. I don't think we design, how many of you design shear keys in your course here? Great, wonderful. I'm very happy to note that here. Why is the shear key provided? To sliding of the columns. Excellent. Okay, so this is the place, or this is the way by which the shear key is put in. You can see the gap which is made here. So the column will go in, and then the gap is grouted. Okay, so the grout is a very costly material. You have to know the size of the pocket, and thereby you will be estimating the amount of grout. Okay, so here concreting is going on, but I don't know, suppose you are able to see much of what is happening there. Maybe I should take a close up and show. Right, this is a cruciform column, I section which is cut. You can see some plates which are kept to this one, but again this is not a very clear shot. So this is how you connect cleats, angles back to back. Okay, back to back it's cut, and then it's welded in place. You got a gusset to which you connect the whole thing. So the, these are all just tie members. Okay, so the, yeah, here it is. Actually that concreting work which was there, I'm just expanding it. So this is a construction joint which is being done. See, the columns are fully apart. Okay, and you can also see that reinforcement is there only in one side of the side shutter. Okay, these are some of the things which you can observe in this drawing, if you're in this photograph, if you're able to see it. And this is an even greater close-up.
See, these are polycarbonate sheets which are there.
So
this is another material
again.
This will be in square meters.
You can see the
on
gap
sheet
between
you
the
measure,
elements.
This is slightly costly, so you have to be a little careful when you are estimating costs. Okay. So now, can you,
yes,
if you go to GDN building, you can see that they have placed a lintel only over this area. Okay, so this is called a cut lintel. You can also measure it in, if it's
okay,
a ready meeting, it can be measured in numbers. Because
okay,
that's an item
which
you buy. Okay. So
yeah,
again here the sunshade,
to another,
see the profile
file
of the sunshade, I'm sure you'll understand what I mean. So,
okay, now, see, these are polycarbonate sheets
which
are there.
Which is there. Okay, this is made
this
of
another material.
Plate.
Again, this will be in square meters.
Handrail. Okay,
on
all these
side sheeting
are
when you measured,
in
this is
running
costly
meters.
So you have to be
handrails are measured in running meters. Although
cost,
this is a steel
okay
structure,
so,
it is measured in
now,
running meters. Okay. Here,
you, if you go to
the size
GDN building,
the,
you can see that they have placed
the lintel
only over
this is the channel which is used.
Okay,
you will
so
find that it is usually marked on each of the.
You can also measure it in,
each
if it's
of
a ready it will be measured in numbers.
Steel structural element
which
you purchase.
Okay.
So some,
again, here the sunshade.
Before
see the profile
in
of the sunshade, I'm sure you'll understand what I mean.
Okay, so light partitions. Okay, light partitions are measured in square meters.
This
for instance, you got a light
there
partition.
Okay,
in
this
your
is made of checkered plate.
These are all measured in square
handrails
meters.
Okay, all these handrails
but it's
are measured
in square
meters. Running meters.
So
handrails are measured in running
what
meters.
What I would like to press
at
this point is,
it is measured
you need to understand that
meters.
Same
okay
item of
here,
work when it's done
the
differently,
size of the, what
you
is
will
the
have
size
different MC160. Cost.
This is the channel.
Now this work
used
is called.
You'll
DADO
find that it is usually marked on each of the.
This DADO is measured in square meters. However, can you see the skirting which is here? The one in the bottom skirting is measured in running meters. Tile work only.
Okay,
however,
so
the item being different, the cost
partitions
is also
okay, light partitions
different
are measured in square
okay
meters.
Your urinals
instance,
and your
you light
toilet
in your bathroom
are measured in numbers.
These are all measured in
okay
square
and
meters.
Weathering
this
post,
wall,
the DPC and whatever we talked about,
meters.
See, it is
so,
this is there in GDN. So it is also
like
an item which you will have to measure.
To
depending on the type of DPC which
you
use, you will find that the unit of measure is slightly varying. Okay, so again we are talking in the initial stages, right? Windows and ventilators, costs are going to be
this DADO
different
is measured
okay
in square
so
meters.
You can see the
however
ventilator which is
can you see
here
the skirting
in all
which
these
is
you
here
can make a deduction of
the one at the bottom
okay
skirting is
so
measured in
so this is a steel
meters
grill work
tile work
grill work
however
it's measured in kgs
different the
however
cost is also going
you'll
to
find
be
that the
different
painting
okay
is
your urinals and your
it is,
toilet
the painting
measured in numbers
is done with a coefficient
okay. And
the painting surface
and
is much higher than
about, see,
the surface
is,
which is
this is there in GDN.
Okay, so the cost
so
might be
this also an
different
item which you
okay
will
then
have
this is the
to
expansion
measure
joint
depending
expansion
on the type of
usually measured in
you use, you'll find
running
the unit
meters
of
okay
measure is slightly
handrail
varying.
We
okay
talked
so
about
again we were
okay
talking
running
the
meters
stages right windows and
plinth protection is there
costs are going to be
plinth protection
different.
Okay I'm not
you can see the ventilator now in all these you can make a deduction of
fine. So this is a rolling shutter. Okay.
So this is a steel grill work. Grill work, it's measured in kgs. However,
okay, this is
you'll find that the painting is
and of course there's a crane guard inside our place itself. Now think about how you can do the
okay
painting estimate for this
surface
house.
Is much
look
higher
the colors
than the surface.
This is one of my neighbor's house. Okay.
Okay. So the cost might be
these
different
are foundation bolts. See, can you
the
see there's a gap
joint,
between,
between
the pedestal and the
running meters
lamppost.
Okay.
You can go and see this is handrail taken near our flag post. Okay. So usually what happens
is
this
there
gap between these two is grouted.
Okay,
this is required
not,
because you need to level the surface. There's no
much
guarantee that all the four
no
foundation bolts were at the same level, right? So
fine
if you want to keep
so
it truly vertical, they'll keep this gap below and then they'll use screws to finally make it to come into
okay, this is
alignment.
Jolly
okay
works.
You can see it more clearly in this one.
And of course,
can you see there's a bolt at the bottom? This is nothing
now
but a flag
think
post.
About how you
okay
can do the painting
so
estimate
all
for
these
this
things
house
are there in
look
VAT
at the colors.
This
one,
this is
one
some firefighting
okay
pipes. Although
these are foundation
is,
see,
I did, this
see
is not from
gap between
VAT
the between the pedestal and the
so solar
lamppost. You can go and see
work,
this
which is
taken near our
the
flag post. Okay.
Construction works.
So usually what happens
so
is
here you can see
this gap
cut lintel. This
is
this is also near
is
on the way to VAT.
You need to level
this,
the surface.
Building
there's
is
no
there
guarantee that all the four foundation bolts
so
were at the same level, right?
Slab shuttering. Okay.
You want to keep it truly vertical.
Shuttering is also another important item of work which you will be machining. Okay. So shuttering for the bottom
alignment
is different
okay
from the
you can
shuttering
see
at the sides
in this one.
So the cost
can
will
see a
be different
at the
so you measure
this
it separately.
Look
at this
okay
item is the
so
same shuttering
things are there
but since the cost
VAT
varies you will be separating. What is the separation here? Vertical shuttering and shuttering for soffit. This is not beam bottom and slab bottom. It will be the same.
So solar side of the beam or side of the slab
also is different. Okay.
So here
you can see the side shuttering which is being put into place for this.
On the way to VIT only that is. Building is there.
You can see the side shuttering on top so, over here. Okay, it's not too clear.
Shuttering. Okay, shuttering. Yeah, shuttering is also another important item.